issued in a non-negotiable form indicating the name concerning. So here we are talking about the transport document being used by the multimodal transport operator. When they say issued in a negotiable form, they are talking about what documents? And then non-negotiable form is what? Yes. And they are special bill of lading for multimodal transportation and special what? Waivers for multimodal transportation. Okay? Now, taking in charge, what does it mean of taking in charge? It means that the goods have been handed over to and accepted for carriage by MTO. So when you take your goods to the MTO to be shipped for you, you pay him and leave the goods to him. Whatever he keeps it before the vessel comes is not your problem. But if anything happens to the goods, the MTO will be held responsible because he has taken in the goods. He has received it. What does delivery means? And they have three options. Handing over the goods to the consignee, or the placing of the goods at the disposal of the consignee in accordance with the multimodal transport contract, or with the law of usage of the particular trade applicable at the place of what? Delivery, or the handing over of the goods to an authority or other third party to whom, pursuant to the law or regulations applicable at the place of delivery, the goods must be handed over. Either you hand over directly to the consignee, or to a place, or to a person who has been directed by the consignee to receive the goods. That's all. That's what it means. But it's because of the legal jargons. Now, special driving right. Okay, SDR. It means the unit of account as defined by the International Monetary Fund, as I told you. You can't go to the chop bar or restaurant and eat and pay in SDR. Okay, if you happen to be given SDR by the IMF, you have to convert it to dollars, maybe from the Bank of Ghana, and then you can have usable money. Now, goods. Goods means any property, okay? Including live animals, as well as containers, pallets or similar articles of transport or packaging not supplied by the MTU. Anything you want to ship that you give to the MTU are goods. I hope you have me. Irrespective of whether such property is to be or is carried on or under deck. So we are saying that whether your goods are above deck or below deck, they are all goods. It's going to be live animals and then any other thing. Dead bodies normally don't come by sea. They will normally come by air because they need to be moved very fast before they open their eyes. Okay, so that is it for the goose. So please don't let this definition for me. Huh? You have some in the exams, not in the class test. Good. So, all these things, you don't need them, okay? You don't need them because they are not necessary. Okay, the period of responsibility. The responsibility of the MTO for the goods under these rules covers the period from the time the MTO has taken the goods in its charge to the time of their delivery. I think I've already explained this. Okay? The MTO is responsible for the shipper's goods from the time he received it until the time he has delivered it. Are you okay? Good. Read this for yourself, okay? And read also this one for yourself. Read this also for yourself. Read this one for yourself. That's what I'm saying today. We are moving like Concord, eh? You don't need it. It's all good for your consumption later,
yes,
but not for my exams. So I don't want you to waste my time and to waste your time. Okay, so the formula we are going to use, limitation of liability of the multimodal transport operator. Now, take note that the goods you are giving to the MTU may be very expensive. That if something happens, he can't pay all the money to you. So the law tells him the limit to which he should pay. And that's the formula we are going to learn how to use. So if you give, that's why you also need to insure your goods, so that whatever the MTO gives you as a compensation, the insurance can also top it up, and then you get closer to your original value. Are you with me? So this formula, I'll show you how to use it on Thursday. Right. So let me see. I think there's something I want you to okay, the same thing here. Yeah. And then we come to, so read this one when you finish, when you pass all your models, eh? And you don't have anything to do, you can read them. Alright, time bar, good. The MTO shall, unless otherwise expressly agreed, be discharged of all liability under this rules, unless a suit is brought within 9 months from the delivery of the goods. Now, if you are a shipper and you give your goods to MTO and you find out that at the destination some of the goods are damaged, some are stolen, you have 9 months to bring the case before the MTO. If you go beyond the 9 months, it's dead case. Pardon? Yes. So in that case, so you have 9 months, and 9 months is enough for you. Okay? And normally, if you are making a claim against an MTO, you'll be ready to go to court for about 2 years. Okay? Yes, I mean, negotiation, I mean, these issues are not, you have to do thorough investigations. Okay? All right. So I think that's what I want you to know. So you are finished with the ICC UMTAD rules. I'm going to stop here. That's 165. I only have 35 more. And then the rest will be your test, your class test, your assignment, and then the tutorials. That's what I'm saying to you. You move like Concord Aeroplane. All right? That's what I am. So for now, I'm going to give you assignments. And then you depart. The assignment, you bring it on the last day. That is next week, Thursday. Okay? And there's a very simple question. I've told you that it's not directly from the notes. You can discuss it and then write it in your own words.